the 18th verse of the third chapter of the book of Habakkuk. So move quickly into work. The 18th chapter, the 18th verse of the third chapter of the book of Habakkuk. And this is what we find in the New Living Translation. Yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will be joyful in the God of my salvation. Repeat these words after me. Yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I want you to put a big smile on your face. Put a big smile on your face. Muster it up and look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, oh neighbor, the yet of praise. Oh, come on, come on. Look across the room at somebody. Smile at them now and say, neighbor, oh neighbor, I didn't come to bother you. I didn't come to stir your Kool-Aid. But I want you to know, I found my yet of praise. Wonderful God, in Jesus' name, we thank you now. Bless your people. Help the preacher in Jesus' name. And all of God's folks said, amen. Ushers, you may be seated. The yet of praise. It has been tougher on some, Dr. Tammy, than others. Yet, I still have a praise. Took longer than I expected and caused major frustration. And yet, I still have a praise. It was devastating and obviously inconvenience. Yet, I still have a praise. It was costly and imposed its will. Yet, I still have a praise. A praise. It destroyed, demolished, and displaced. Yet, I still have a praise. It was painful for some and horrible for others. Yet, I still have a praise. It uprooted and discarded. Yet, I still have a praise. For some, things remain the same. For others, things will never be the same. Yet, I still have a praise. Long days of jagged and sleepless night. Yet, I still have a praise. It's aggravated and caused some to be disgusted. Yet, I still have a praise. Some left never to be heard from again. Yet, I still have a praise. Nothing tangible to hold on to, but memories. Yet, I still have a praise. Staring, I can't explain it. Others deny it, or more are to follow. Yet, I still have a praise. Yes, I declare and decree that I still have a praise inside of me. Tears have fallen and streams have been made, Mother Herb. Yet, I still have a praise. Mother Herb, I refuse to allow any circumstance to assassinate my praise. I refuse to allow, angel, any adversity to separate me from my faith in God. This rain, I praise God because God is God. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, oh neighbor, God is God. And guess what? Because God is God, Dr. Herbert, God can do and God will do anything that God wants. Therefore, in the midst of trouble, storms, hurricanes, blizzards, natural disasters, human-made events, terrorism, foolery, or anything else, I choose to hang my faith on the can-do of God. Do I have anybody that you're going to hang your faith on? to have originated from a period between 609 and 597 before Common Era. The book of Habakkuk has become known to the church primarily through a single phrase printed in the King James Version that says, "The just shall live by faith." This phrase was quoted by the Apostle Paul in his letter to the Romans, chapter 1, verse 17, also in the King James Version. It is unclear as to whether Habakkuk served in or near the Jerusalem temple as part of some kind of cult personnel, but it is clear that there is no other personal information that is contained in this brief book. The central theme and issues in the book include the prophet's observation of unrelenting violence and injustice both within and beyond Judea. The prophet's perception that Babylon, as the embodiment of evil in history, and the prophet's recognition that the ways of God are profoundly disturbing and do not easily conform to the human expectations of divine power of justice. Check it out. Habakkuk is not in a fight with God. Habakkuk is man with God. Habakkuk gives voice to a persistent and troubling problem that challenges the prophet's confidence in God's justice, which is the perseverance of injustice in the world. In other words, Zion, Habakkuk's problem was maintaining a belief in God's just rule in spite of an unjust world. Beloved, we are challenged to believe in the ultimate power of justice in a world that appears to be overwhelmingly unjust. Check it out. 45's White House wants ESPN to fire Jemele Hill for her tweet of calling 45 a white supremacist when 45 promulgated birtherism against 44, the first African-American president. 7 million people from the state of Florida were told to evacuate, but how do you provide for the most vulnerable among us? Again, we are challenged to believe, in spite of the evidence, that injustice is winning. Habakkuk is mad with God. As many of us share our frustrations with God, Habakkuk begins to run down his laundry list of things that are not right. He gives voice to our frustrations. This is what Habakkuk told God the other day. The power went out. Food in the refrigerator will soon be swollen. The ham hock that I had in the deep freezer is now in jeopardy. No TV, no power, no power to charge my phone. The phone line's down. Direct TV isn't working. Cable is down. I'm living in the dark on a dark street with no light. And to top it off, the children are out of school for the whole week. Somehow, Habakkuk, in the midst of his laundry list, found a yet of praise. I know I'm right about it. In the midst of unchanged circumstances, Habakkuk found a yet. In the midst of intense delay, Habakkuk found a yet. I believe that in spite of all the things going on in your life right now, you ought to be able to find your yet. Come on, beloved, I want you to sit with me just for a few minutes and let us together examine Habakkuk's yet of praise. Y'all ready to get on the train? I'm ready to go. I believe, beloved, that you can praise God. Yes, you can, during unchanged circumstances, because you ready, Gail? God is your salvation. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, oh neighbor, God is my salvation. Look at the text. Look at the text in verse 18b. Look at the text. It says, the New Revised Standard Version, I will exalt in the God of what? My salvation. Somebody shout salvation.
See, no matter what you are facing, God is your help. You might as well surrender your notion of doing it all by yourself, because it won't work, baby. You're just fooling yourself. God is your help. That is what salvation means. It means help. Somebody shout help. You see, all my help comes from the Lord. It means that when you find yourself in trouble, God will come to your rescue. Somebody shout rescue. You see, when you are facing adversity and turmoil, God will come to your rescue. Not only will God rescue you, but God being your salvation will also be your liberator. Somebody say, I'm free. Somebody listening to me right now.
Yes.
Say, neighbor or neighbor, I got an army with me. I know you thought I was walking by myself, but I got an army with me because God is my strength. I know you thought you had me cornered, but I got an army with me. You see, 2 Isaiah said he gives power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increases their strength.
Thank you.
I don't know if you know the church.